Well, hello out there. So if you're tuning in, it may be because you have received a LSAT score that you would have preferred not to have received. And you may not be the first one. And you may further infer from that score that law school is something that you're not going to be able to achieve. And that you're watching this video is some evidence that you haven't fully accepted that proposition. So let's go there. So I'm Peter Gormanly. I've been a lawyer since 1987. And I run the focus approach and work with law schools, Albany Law School, Pace Law School, and Touro Law School in developing pipeline programs for students who want to approach LSAT preparation in a materially different way than the standard courses. So here's the deal. It is certainly possible your result reflects your ability. That is absolutely a possibility. Not everybody's a lawyer, not everybody's supposed to be a lawyer, and you have to deal with that. That said, I'm quite convinced there are tons and tons of people out there who don't go to law school, not because they weren't able to get into law school, but because the method they used was flawed. Now, you know, everybody learns in a different way. So it's not about one size fits all, one size does not fit all. But if the method you use is flawed for you, if the method is itself flawed, then the outcome will be flawed. And so, it need not be the case that the LSAT score reflects your ability. It may well reflect the method you employed to prepare for the test. So, you know, what if you didn't understand the tests? What if you've not been made aware that the test is psychometric? So if you're hearing this is a psychometric test and you've not heard that before, well, you know, what does it mean? Well, it means it's not an academic test. It means it's very, very, very much a test that's measuring your psychology and how you approach problem solving, because lawyers, that's what we do. We are forward. We solve problems we look out. In other words, when a client comes into your life, you're looking out. You're trying to solve something. You're trying to say, well, do this, take a plea, go to trial. But that event hasn't happened yet. That's very different from academics, where you're reaching back, where you're saying, well, let me remember what I learned about whatever you learned, right? And you're bringing that forward. So you're going from the back forward, but law, you're not. Law, you're moving into the unknown, if you will. So look, the LSAT is going to respond to the type of preparation you've done. The LSAT is it is predictive of how you will perform in law school. I mean, stop the BS, right? This is predictive of how you will perform in law school. Now, it's a correlation, right? It doesn't apply to a specific individual, but it does apply, and it is a compelling correlation between your first year law school grade point average and this LSAT score. So, you know, how about you give something else a try? We're being lawyers, you learn to reason. The method of reasoning we all use is IRAC. It's issue, rule, application, conclusion, or issue, rule, analysis, conclusion. But it's how we're taught to reason. It's how we're taught to reach outcomes. And that's what the LSAT is measuring. And if no one has mentioned IRAC to you, well, then maybe the method was flawed. If nobody's mentioned it's a psychometric test to you, well, then certainly the method is flawed. And so this really is an opportunity to you to revisit the issue of whether this is something you can get your arms around. And you should accept the affirmative proposition until the evidence tells you otherwise. I'm a first generation lawyer. Almost everybody involved, if not everybody involved, in the pipeline programs we run, and in the course of the LSAT preparation program we run, is first generation. So we didn't have anybody there. So rather than despair, why don't you use this as an opportunity? You can pick up the phone and call me. And that's, you know, 914-763-0128. You can send me an email, which is focusapproachllc@gmail. So send me an email. We'll have an event on May 22nd and May 23rd. We're going to have Albany Law School, Pace Law School, Toro Law School, Seton Hall Law School, and they'll come and at the very least, you'll get to be introduced to the admissions folks there. But some of those law schools will also be exploring the pipeline programs, how to prepare for the LSAT in a fundamentally different way. How do you prepare for this in a way that prepares you for law school? So that's what this is about. Shoot off an email or give me a call and come and just touch this thing and see if this method can work for you. Thank you very much.